New reports have revealed crazy new information about the Shang Chi movie. Let's break down these new plot points and how they will fit into what we think we already know about the Marvel Cinematic Universe's Phase 4. What's up, everybody? It's Josh. Welcome back to the channel. Use your martial arts prowess to chop that like button. And let's get right into this video. Oh, and two real quick side notes. There's a ton of crazy Marvel news that just came out yesterday. So expect multiple videos on the channel today and probably some videos tomorrow about all this crazy stuff that's coming out. I just need to distance the videos so that YouTube doesn't crush them. And number two, yes, I do have a quarantine hair problem going on. I don't know what to do about it. Okay, so this is coming from Fandom Wire. Andy Signor broke this, scooped it from his sources. There's an article on fandomwire.com, and Andy did a video on his channel, Popcorn Planet, that goes over these leaks. And as far as the validity of Andy as a scooper and Fandom Wire and all of that stuff, I'll just be completely honest with you. I feel as though it's not hard to imagine Andy having some actual sources still in Hollywood or in Atlanta. So I'm sure that he does have sources, but we're going to have to look at some of the other scoops that he's been talking about recently and sort of see his track record in action after some of these films actually come out. I will say, though, that his talk about the Snyder Cut and what was going on over there was corroborated by the Illuminati, which has been pretty good in their scoop record as well. So for now, I'm going to run with this. I think that it's probably true, but we're going to have to wait and see how this turns out, and then we'll sort of go back and judge Andy and Fandom Wire as far as their ability as scoopers. And there's a couple of things in here that are also corroborated by just other things we've been reporting about and talking about for almost months now at this point. So there's some stuff in here that's kind of old news, but there's juicy new stuff that I want to get to as well. But let's go over the stuff that we already knew. Number one, Tony Leung will be the Mandarin. We know this. We've known this for a long, long time. Essentially, late last year, I believe, we knew that he was going to be the Mandarin. We knew that he was going to be the actual Mandarin, and it was going to have some commentary on the Trevor Slattery character from Iron Man 3, and we were going to get that. So that's in this scoop, but we sort of already knew. Another thing is about the fact that it's going to have this martial arts tournament that's going to be the centerpiece of the movie, very Bloodsport or Mortal Kombat. Again, we have known this for months. Different scoopers have talked about this, Marvel insiders have talked about this, and plot leaks have come out that all seem to mention this tournament. It seems to be the most commonly known thing about the plot, so that was in there as well. Now, as far as the things that we didn't know before, this is where it gets interesting for me, because in this scoop, they talk about the fact that Shang-Chi is going to be an orphan, and he's actually raised in an orphanage that is run by the Mandarin. To the best of my knowledge, that is completely new information. We had actually speculated, based on a lot of the grids and a lot of the crazy things that were coming out from insiders, that the Mandarin was actually going to be Shang-Chi's father. It appears that that is not the case, and we'll get into his sister and things like that in a little bit here, but I find the idea of the orphanage and the idea that the Mandarin had sort of raised him in an orphanage as really cool. That's interesting. Also, Shang-Chi, as he gets older, escapes that orphanage and lives constantly on the run from the Mandarin. The Mandarin is constantly looking for him to bring him back to the orphanage, and so Shang-Chi has just literally been living on the run. That's pretty interesting, and as far as I know, that was not covered by anybody or in any plot leak. Now, Andy mentions the special power that Shang-Chi has, and this is really fascinating to me, as he described this sort of cloning ability that we do see in Marvel Comics recently, and then again in some animated stuff. It's a lot like that multi-form that Naruto uses in that anime as well, and so it's cool that that aspect is going to be in the film. But when we get into speculation on this video, I'll talk about how I don't think that's the only power that Shang-Chi will have, and him even having this power leads me to believe that a whole list of other comic book powers that Shang-Chi has will be in the film. Next up, Fallow Sue will be played by Awkwafina. And this is interesting because we already knew that Awkwafina was going to be playing this character. However, that character of Fal in the comics is actually Shang-Chi's sister. Now, this is where, way back, I want to say late last year, we were speculating, and as a community, a lot of people were speculating that the Mandarin was going to be sort of twisted and become the father of Shang Chi. And this was because of the Awkwafina casting. Most of us assumed that because they are brother and sister in the comics, they would be brother and sister again, and then that would make the Mandarin Shang-Chi's father. Well, it appears that's not the case. According to Andy and Phantom Wire, Fa Losu will actually be a love interest. She will be the daughter of the Mandarin, but she will be a love interest for Shang-Chi. That is interesting, and as far as I know, completely new information. Now, the last cool thing I want to mention from Andy's article is the mention that there's going to be absolutely crazy things going on in the tournament. Now, we have known for at least a month, maybe a month and a half, that the tournament is circling around the 10 rings, that essentially whoever wins the tournament will get the 10 rings. Now, early on, there was some confusion as to whether or not the Mandarin would be putting on the tournament. He already had the rings and he was going to give them to someone else, but it appears that he does not have the rings and he is trying to get the rings, and that is why he's going to have this tournament, to have the winner of this tournament gain access to the 10 rings, and then likely he'll get the 10 rings himself. Now, in the plot leak that Andy is talking about, basically the Mandarin tracks down Shang-Chi and makes him fight in the tournament, and the offer he gives Shang-Chi is that he'll give him wealth and power and also no longer hunt him. So Shang-Chi can finally be free and he'll no longer have to be on the run. That is very interesting. Of course, the Mandarin wants the 10 rings for himself. But in the mentioning of this crazy tournament, Andy goes on to talk about how there will be wizards, aliens, fighters, and well-known Marvel characters hanging out in the tournament, and that is just fantastic for me. When he said wizards, I automatically thought of Mordu, and man, oh man, would that be awesome. Or maybe some other people from Carmitage are actually going to fight in this tournament. That would be really freaking cool. And aliens is so interesting too, because you could get alien races that we haven't been introduced to yet in the MCU, or crazy things like that. So I want to see some aliens. I think that sounds amazing. But now let's get into speculation. Take my hand and let's go to speculation town. Now, number one, this is a really interesting scoop, right? Because it actually does pull a lot of the threads we'd already been like playing with and thinking about together. It makes sense that he's not actually the son of the Mandarin, although that could be a plot twist they do in the movie anyways. But if they're going to make the daughter be the love interest, that's probably not going to happen. But also the fact that the Mandarin does not have the 10 rings. He wants the 10 rings really badly. Now, just using my comic book knowledge here, what I think is going to happen is there'll be some kind of time frame here on this tournament. If the orphanage, if its purpose is to raise people to fight in these tournaments, then it's very possible that there's some time restraint on when the tournament to be held for the 10 rings can take place. Maybe it only happens once every 20 years or something to that effect, and the Mandarin has been trying to get somebody to win this tournament for a long, long time. Of course, these are actually alien technology, and an alien shapeshifter that takes the form of a dragon in Fin Fang Foom is actually the one that will be tied to the rings and is rumored to be in the film. Now, the director, Dustin Cretton, has literally teased a dragon and Dragon Ball Z-like stuff when he was brought out on stage at San Diego Comic-Con last year. And so I think Shang-Chi is going to have way more than just that multi-form power. I think he's going to be able to use his chi, much like what we saw with Iron Fist, but hopefully much more upgraded. And he'll be sort of doing that, like just using his chi, doing crazy Dragon Ball Z-type fighting and using that multi-form, which again, has a very anime thing. I mean, Naruto uses that. I'm trying to think of any Dragon Ball Z characters use that. I don't really think so. I mean, maybe the after image technique, but not really. But that just sounds dope either way. Special powers, Dragon Ball Z-like powers given to Shang-Chi, way cooler than him just being a very good martial artist. I was hoping they would sort of tease that. I'm glad that the scoop broke, because that multi-form is going to be dope, and leads me to believe he'll have a lot more power other than that. Now, the only thing I'm really wondering about is this whole idea of MI6. There have been several insiders and several plot leaks that have mentioned MI6 and British intelligence as being involved in this film. In fact, a lot of these leaks suggested that it would be British intelligence that would bring Shang-Chi in to actually fight in the tournament, and that maybe Shang-Chi had been involved with MI6 before. Now, either that stuff's all bullcrap, or it's not something that Andy's source knew about, or it actually is all going to fit together. And there'll be this MI6 element that is also a part of this movie that maybe just wasn't uncovered in Andy's scoop. I don't know what to think there. It's like weird because a lot of these plot leaks seem to tie into this idea of the tournament, and the 10 rings had been mentioned a lot, but it's like, how much of this is just good prognostication by really smart comic book nerds, and how much of it came from actual sources? I think this is a great next step in knowing what to expect for Shang-Chi, and frankly, it's got me really, really excited. But of course, feel free to let us know what you think about this scoop and all the crazy possibilities for Shang-Chi in the comment section below. And now let's shout out McGuffle. Yes, indeed, the magic sword that magic uses is called the Soul Sword. So shout out to you, McGuffle. And now let's ask another nerd card question before we get out of here. I want to know, what area of the Marvel Universe in the Marvel comics does Kazar call home? Softball if you're a comic book reader, but yeah, where's the home base of Kazar from Marvel Comics? Answer that question in the comment section below. If you absolutely need more nerdy content in your life, click or tap over there to get lost on a nerdy rabbit hole on some of our content, or come on by our live streaming channel where we do live streams every morning at 10 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. Like this video if you liked it, or if you want to take your support to the next level and join the list of amazing people you see below, check out our Patreon for behind the scenes content. As I always say, I hope you're having an awesome and a nerdy day, and I'll see you in the next video.